Thank you for being with us on Breakfast. As we heard just before the break, Hayley talking to Katie, a One News comma Brunton poll has revealed something about voter preferences for what the government should do with its surpluses. We're going to get a significant insight into the government's plans today with the announcement of the infrastructure spending. Grant Robertson flagged at the Labor Party conference last month, of course. Lots to discuss with National Leader Simon Bridges, who is with us in the studio today. Kia ora, welcome. It's nice to have you here. I want to begin with your trip to Whakatāne yesterday. Yeah. What did you find? And I guess I want to reflect on the fact that this tragedy is very particular and very personal, and also a big one as well, right?
Yeah.
So there have been human lives lost and altered forever because of the critical burn suffered by people. But also, this is a community dependent on the tourism from Whakatāne White Island.
Yes.
What did you find when you were there?
And I saw all of that, meeting with iwi and White Island tour operators, right? They've got those things going on. I mean, I think it's very humbling, right? I mean, it might sound a bit twee, but I genuinely felt it and mean it. It just shows you what a great country we have, what great people. A very clear sense from the first responders, council, iwi, that their priority, everything they're thinking about is the people, the victims, and that the rest will sort of follow later, you know, because there are questions and so on, but they're not, that's not where their headspace is. And I thought that was incredibly impressive, really.
It's a hell of a hard balancing act to get right for us, isn't it? Because there is a sense still of New Zealand as being a frontier place. And people come here, as Hayley was saying before, people come here to jump off bridges with giant pieces of elastic tied to their, you know, so...
I mean, someone was telling me about a New York Times, I think, editorial or something, is it effectively saying, should people be on volcanoes? And of course, these are questions that people you know, can and should ask. And I think in due course, you know, there'll be some sort of official level response to these things. But I think you're right. My instinct is, you know, we shouldn't be cavalier about it. We should be sensible. We should be following what GNS says. But, you know, people do want to do these things and they have been doing them for 100 years. And so, you know, if you think about it, Ruapehu, people go skiing at level 2. And that's the sort of... a warning they had here. Mm. So there are all these questions, but you're right, very mixed sort of views on them.
Right, let's talk about the half-year economic and fiscal update, which has got real salt and pepper attached to it because we're going to hear something of what Grant Robertson flagged in Whanganui at the Labor Party conference. Have you got an expectation of what the surplus figure will be?
No. And I mean, I think what I would sort of say is spending is important, right? There's no doubt about it. What's more important is growing the economy. And I think we've sort of, with GDP not being where it's been forecast, you're about $5 billion down. That's a lot of tax. So that does mean it's less you can do and it is less money in people's pockets.
So what are you saying Grant Robertson should do? What are you saying he should do today?
What I would do is I would have a focus on less tax, less debt, less wasteful spending. And I think then actually, funnily enough, if you're growing the economy, if you're not wasting it on, you know, Shane Jones, on embassies for Winston, etc., you can do a lot. What would I do? I'll tell you very quickly. Three priorities and three only from that redirected spending and not, you know, mucking around with anything much else. Health, education, infrastructure, and according with your poll, actually, I also think tax relief, because in reality is there are a lot of New Zealanders who are feeling more burden on top of the burdens they already have, and we've talked about them many times in terms of rent, petrol and the like. And actually, as I say, if you're not borrowing too much, if you keep your costs down, if you're growing the economy, if you're not wasting cash, I think you can do those things.
So you think you can do health, education, infrastructure and tax relief?
I think you can.
Okay. One of the things that was being discussed before the break is that Grant Robertson's actually a very orthodox finance minister.
Yep.
Are you saying he should take more risks?
Not necessarily, because I think what you're going to see today is that they will claim, well, we're going to borrow and break our promises to the electorate. But the reason we're going to do that is all this infrastructure. Look, that's not my view.
I just want to interrupt there.
Yep.
Do you think it's wrong? So we're talking about their targets of what? Less than 20% of debt is less than 20% of GDP, which is low relative to the rest of the OECD. Do you think it's wrong for them to do that?
I do actually think it's wrong, because I think the end of all of this, whilst they will portray it as about infrastructure, the truth is $2 billion Kiwi Bill, $2-something billion is it fees-free, $3 billion on Shane Jones, $1 billion, $1.5 billion Winston Peters
so
and embassies.
Saying, okay,
I'm saying to you actually, if you if you stick to your knitting of what really matters to people and spending people's money on them and their families, health, education, infrastructure and money back in the pocket, I don't think we're in a situation we need to be borrowing lots of money.
So you're saying don't borrow, even though interest rates are the lowest they have ever been and our percentage of debt relative...
Because ultimately, you have to, you and your family, pay it back. And I say right now, there's the headroom there. Take infrastructure, right? It's fundamentally quite simple. They've been taxing more. They can't even spend it, right? They're not spending that extra $1.7 billion they've taken in right now. We've had, and people can argue about them, but a big Roads of National Significance program. This government stopped that. Now, there's a few projects coming to an end. That leaves quite a lot of headroom in about that $4 billion fund. I think, actually, if the Crown says, you know what, we're not going to waste money on this, that and the other thing, they can redirect money into infrastructure. We can really get New Zealand moving. And I don't accept the sort of the trendy line of, you know, Shamabil Jacob and these others. Oh, no, absolutely got to borrow.
What infrastructure would you spend the money on?
Well, that's going to be the point today, I think.
I'm asking
yep,
you.
And I'll tell you. What's the plan, right? I think spray and walk away is easy, but
Hold on, I'm asking you.
And I'm going to tell you, right? I suspect they'll say, oh, well, we're going to put some more money into rail, this, then the other thing. I believe that's fine, but in truth, we want projects that you and I, that our freight, will actually go on. That gets mum to school, that gets the tradie across town. And I can tell you, in Auckland, that would be things like Mill Road. That would be things like the North Western Busway.
Penlink. So when I ask you about infrastructure spending, your answer, as it was when you were Minister of Transport, is roads.
I think that over 90% of us and our freight travels by roads. That's incredibly important. Remember, though, we did the electrification of rail. I started personally CRL. I'm not anti this stuff, but I do think if this is basically just pie in the sky, not a whole lot here, not some real new roads starting, they're not going to turn the dial for congestion in Auckland. Actually, they're not going to get New Zealanders moving around this country.
Simon Richards, thank you so much for joining
us. Thank you.
Next week, we're going to look back over the year and reflect on what's ahead for election year. Thank you so much for coming up, Simon Richards. We'd love your feedback on that. What would you like the infrastructure spend to be on? What is important to you?
Yeah, so there's roads, there's rail, there's hospitals, schools. That they've already announced spending for school infrastructure. Which is it's an easy one to get going.
It's a fascinating business too, because infrastructure takes planning, it takes resource consents, it takes a whole lot of work up front before you can actually start the construction. But local government's already done a lot of that planning, so maybe the government will piggyback on local government infrastructure projects or start funding those. But
imagine
we will find out from one this afternoon.
Government agencies talking to each other.
Yeah.
Amazing.